Hello everyone, welcome to the first real commentary on my channel. Today's topic is really focused on reality television and kind of a case study of one show in particular called Mountain Monsters. Now, the beauty of this show is that it's a great example of how a reality television executive sees the modern TV audience. Some of you probably saw Kill Bill Volume 2 and the part where David Carradine, rest in peace, the guy who went to the noose like no other. There's a part where David Carradine is giving this great analysis of Superman. And he's talking about the fact that the persona of Clark Kent is really a reflection of Superman's view of humanity. It's how he sees us. It's how he sees people in general. That in the creation of Clark, he adopts what he perceives to be human qualities. And so there's this whole great exposition. It's near the end of Kill Bill Volume 2. And in many ways, reality television is that same type of exercise. It's considering, you know, your audience and then producing content that reflects the sensibilities, the intelligence, or lack thereof, found in the audience, etc. Now, this show, Mountain Monsters, is brilliant. Now, why do I say that? Because this show, more than any other reality show, takes what I'm saying to the extreme. Now, falls under that cryptozoological, monster hunting, chasing Bigfoot, all of that type of stuff. So, typically, those shows try to retain a sliver of credibility. There's a line. And the idea is that we can talk about monsters, we can talk about ghosts, we can hear sounds, we can find tracks, we can do all of those things. But we want to remain credible. Therefore, we won't show a direct confrontation with a monster. We don't show a ghost, you know, molesting the cameraman or something like that. The brilliance of Mountain Monsters is that somewhere in the world, there was a person that I will call the brain above, TBA, which is just my way of identifying the person who is in the hierarchy above all of what appears to be the silliness and the absurd behavior and severe mental problems. You eventually reach a mind that understands the market, it understands consumers, and it inherently knows what sells and what does not sell. The brain above looked at the typical format and said, I'm guessing it went something like this. How do we differentiate ourselves? If the audience will believe that this guy entered a house, you know, is there a presence in here? I just feel this presence, and I ask that you make yourself known. I ask that you reveal yourself to me. I know you're here. I know you had a tragic death. Please come forward and make yourself known. Whoa, what was that? There's a sound in the pipes. I heard a sound in the pipes. Oh, there's an orb floating. Oh, and there's a toy. You know, the one part I saw, there's a little toy dragon in the corner. It's like, if you're here, make your presence known to us. And the little dragon is like, rawr, 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 rawr. It doesn't even have batteries. Someone looked at that and said, you know, if you'll believe that, and I'm not saying that that's impossible. I'm saying, from the perspective of the television executives, from the producer's perspective, if you will believe that, if you will co-sign that content, then wouldn't it be better, instead of just hearing a sound, what if the guy was like, make your presence known to me right now? And let's say the spirit lifted him into the air, slammed him into the wall, hurled him through a window. Even better, some guy's going to light a cigarette. Next thing you know, he's set ablaze. He's engulfed in flames. Ah! Oh! Oh! Help! Hey, we'll be right back. Cut to commercial. Mountain Monsters is a fascinating case study of the fact that someone has realized there is no line necessarily. Why hold back? You got to go all the way with it. Okay? So if we hear rustling, if we see tracks, all of that, then really, why can't we have a fight? Why can't we have a fist fight? Why can't Bigfoot literally grab your arm so hard that it bruises you and you start wrestling with him? Why can't you go after something called the Bloodless Howler? Look, they saw stuff dripping down from like a tree limb. It was the urine of a sheep squatch. They had a monster that would spray so high that it would hurt the neck to look at it. And they had the tallest member of their team, Huckleberry, lift his leg to emulate the territorial spraying of this supernatural of this supernatural creature. So what I'm saying is that it's a fascinating commentary on how executives see the audience. Reality television is all about exploiting the wiring of the typical viewer. People are obsessed with watching others perform and act, whether it's playing video games here on YouTube, watching someone bake a cake, watching a family assemble motorcycles, watching people run an advertising agency. It doesn't matter. People are obsessed with the lives of others. It isn't simply about living vicariously through your child now. It's living vicariously through anyone that you can find. So, but when it comes to this type of genre, delving into the supernatural, the monsters, the boogeyman, all of that, someone had the brilliant idea that maybe there is no line. Now, I disagree. I've seen comments on some of the pages where people are starting to suspect. It's like what Tyrell says to Harrison Ford in Blade Runner. She's starting to suspect. Like, well, I don't know. Was that real? Like, you guys, I don't know, man. I kind of think that last episode. I mean, they have a Bigfoot on there called the Dust. Yeah, the Dust Man. Who actually etches maps on the walls of his cave system. His quote-unquote underground lair. And when he leaves his lair, when he ventures out to, say, get a loaf of bread and some milk from the corner store, he employs torches. He uses tools. He cooks his own food. And I don't know, maybe he's nice enough. He cooks meat for others in the neighborhood. There was one called the Cherokee Devil that actually introduced mind control to the show. He mind-boinked Buck, and he also took control of their security officer, Huckleberry, to the point. I'm trying to do the whole Mike Wallace thing, but it's difficult. To the point that they found Huckleberry alone, freezing at night, and he's essentially dry humping an evil totem that they found in the woods while howling. I guess at the moon. So, and I love the show. Full disclosure, before anybody says, why is he trapped? Hey, my enjoyment is more for the comedy. It had a thing called, I think, the fire dragon or fire lizard, whatever. And it, they built a bonfire to lure it inside of a trap. And I guess it started flopping around and trying to bone the bonfire, and it got energized from the heat to the point that it totally just incinerated the entire trap. You know, it like Human Torch, it went supernova. And that's when I knew, wow, these guys, this is fascinating, how they see the audience. Yes, this is their reflection of the audience. It is the Superman story from Kill Bill. Mountain Monsters is a reflection of how an executive sees the audience. And it is now the number one show on Destination America, which is its home network. In fact, they're in the process of duplicating the formula with other shows. And as I said, I mean, when the great thing is, even if you're onto it, even if you see through it, it's still hilarious because of how extreme it is. You know, a guy picked up and thrown into the water, you know, as a local basketball player runs off into the forest or something like that. It's amazing. So this is kind of part one of the exploration of reality television. I'll return to it. We'll have more thoughts on it. But yeah, Mountain Monsters. Check that out sometime. And again, as you watch it, just keep in mind that someone decided that this would be very popular. If we put this in front of people, we're set. So, okay, well, that's just a little bit of insight I wanted to share. I will say a lot more about reality television, believe me, but this is a good start. Fascinating stuff. Okay, guys, I will talk to you later. This is WestFactor, and I'm out.